He had laid gamuts on the table. Do we need to get Southwest to get into the position where the rest of the country has been? Is there anything that you think is on the horizon that should frighten any of us?
No, not really. But if you look at the Southwest, we have been able to prevent the Boko Haram from penetrating the Southwest. That could mean the members of the OPC have been at alert. And according to the reports, they are watching every market, every mosque, every church, and ensuring that there is no penetration of Boko Haram insurgency in the South. But of course, that might not be the reason. It could be because the Yoruba people have similarity in culture with the North, and therefore they probably don't think they should attack us or do any harm to us here. Because they have Muslims there, we have a lot of Muslims there. They have Christians there, we have a lot of Christians there. That could also be a reason why this attack is not coming here. So don't let us just
over celebrate.
But the OPC claim they are at alert and they are watching everywhere. We have read in the papers sometimes of OPC wanting to take contracts to protect the pipeline. And people probably have said quite a lot of things. If the militants in the South could be given contract to protect the pipeline, there is no reason why the OPC should also not be given the same opportunity to protect the pipeline in the Southwest. There's no reason at all. There's no reason. That is what I'm saying. This marginalization is getting too far. It's getting too far. We also have been in government before. We did not marginalize everybody. Instead, we marginalize ourselves.
We have the telephone lines right now on the screen, 081-2918-1416, 081-2918-1416. We expect your calls and your comment to take on the conversation with Senator Adefi. Now, the next issue, of course, that we stem from that, won't that be that the rumor going around, or making the rounds now, that the Unity Party of Nigeria is going to be resuscitated and the OPC is going to be used, you know, as a fodder to do that. Won't that therefore be true?
That's not true. That's not true at all. If you realize, the OPC itself is divided into two. We have the Ghanaian Adams-led OPC, and we have Dr. Fashion-led OPC. The Ghanaian Adams-led OPC are not involved
in all this
at all in this UPN thing, and the Fashion thing is what is involved in the UPN thing. Now I want to say to the public, the YUF is completely not involved
in all this.
In all this, we are not involved. We are political, and we do not take part in politics when we are in the YUF. So let nobody be afraid of UPN. But I wish them well.
Okay, now, wishing them well, because UPN now will probably be another progressive arm. Wouldn't that be, I'm just speculating now, because we really don't know exactly where that will be. I think we have a caller online. Okay, let's go to that call. Yes, good morning and you're welcome. Your name and where you're calling from, quickly, please. Oh, we lost the caller.
Yeah.
Please just try and keep calling. I think it's just the network that is misbehaving. Now, so if this party gets to be and it comes under the umbrella of the progressives, so what would be your reaction?
Well, nothing at all. I am a member of ACN and we are graduating into APC, getting bigger and bigger. We are ready for any challenge, and we have performed so well with ACN. If you look from Lagos to Ekiti, you find that we have transformed those states. That's the word to use, transformation. You can look at Lagos, transform, Ogun, transform, Oyo, transform, Osun, Ekiti, you know. Well, the Labour Party in Ondo too has done some transformation. We must give kudos to whoever is giving, you know. So there is a lot of performance in the Southwest generally by the government, because there is a healthy competition between them. And therefore, they are all struggling
to excel
and also to get the confidence of the people, you know. And with that, we are confident in ACN that come any election, we will sweep. If we put our house in order, we will sweep the election.
So we're coming to that issue right now. 2015. Yeah. Now, the agenda on the table is that all the progressives would like to do is to just take PDP out of contention, out of national government. But what exactly would the progressive be putting on the table that is different from what PDP is doing now? Because nobody seems to be clear on that.
Well, I think it's clear. Our performance in the Southwest is a window into what we will do in future for the whole country. It's a window. Just look at it, come to us in the Southwest, see what we are doing, and that gives you an idea what we will do for your state if you let the progressive take over.
But the progressive will have other parties joining, not just parties in Southwest states.
Those who are joining are also progressives. You know, the agenda is being progressive. We are, people of like minds are coming together, and we are expanding our territory. You know quite well that we must have a powerful opposition in Nigeria. The two-party system is probably the best for Nigeria. When we have the SDP and NRC, that was the best time for politics in Nigeria. Since then, we've not had any good politicking at all. And if you look at Britain, if you look at America, it's two-party system. You know, in Britain, when you have a minister of works, you also have a shadow minister of works. You know, and they both are the same.